Hello guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. If you missed the video about data cleaning in Stata and data importation, I've attached the link to those videos above this video. So make sure you check those videos and again, subscribe and hit the bell icon so that you will be notified when I post a video. In our today's class, we are going to talk about simple linear regression in Stata. And we'll start with the assumptions and then the regression. And last but not least, I will explain the output of simple linear regression in Stata. So stay tuned as I take you through this journey of simple linear regression in Stata. Okay, so I don't have my personal data, so I'll be using data from Stata. And I'll go to, you start with file, go to example datasets. There you click here in example datasets. Once you're here, I'm going to use this data. Click use. See, it is already loaded here. Again, if you missed the lesson about data importation, you can find it via the link that I've provided above this video. And so I'm going to close it. Okay, so as you can see, there is age, race, married, never married, or birth. So you can just browse and see through it. Yeah, browse. There you have age, race, married, never married, grade, and all that. But today, I want to see the relationship between wages and the total experience. Therefore, I'm going to regress wages against total experience. But first of all, there are some assumptions that we must meet. Okay. First of all, the first assumption is that the dependent variable, in this case, wage, must be a continuous variable. And you can see it is a continuous variable. The second assumption is that the independent variable, which is total experience, must also be a continuous or a categorical variable. You can see it is continuous. Categorical variable can be something like race. Race is categorical variable. Or even married status. That one is also categorical variable. So now that we know the variables that we want to work with, it is time to test other assumptions. So we test it using a scatter plot. So go to graphics. Okay, I went too fast. Go to graphics. Go to create. You leave it at a scatter plot. Then you choose your dependent variable. This time it is wage. The independent variable, that is total experience. And accept, okay. As you can see from our scatter plot, they have a linear relationship. That is another assumption that is met. It must have a linear relationship. If it was from here to here, it will be an inverse relationship. But this is a linear relationship. Apparently, I can see outliners, like this outliner. One of the assumptions also is that there should be no significant outliners. But my experience working with real life data, it is hard not to get a data with outliners. And also, there should be homoscedasticity, which you can see. So our data, it is good for regression. So let us jump into regression. Okay, I'll minimize this. So to regress, you go to statistics, linear models, and we go to linear regression. dependent variable again. You say it is wage. Independent variable. It is total experience. Click OK. See? It has regressed our wage again as total experience. Okay. So what R squared means? It means the total number of variations in wages that is explained by total experience. Okay. So if we change this into a percentage, it means 7% of variation in wages, they are explained by total experience. So that is what it means. And you can see here the coefficient is positive, which means there is a positive relationship between wages and total experience. Okay. And so having explained that, it is time now to predict, to use the same data to predict future wages based on the total experience. So to do that, you go to graphics, post estimation, you go to prediction residual HTC. Okay, you can name this prediction wages, but you can name it whatever you want. Prediction wages. Leave everything just like that. Okay. And go back to statistics. We go to name this to regular. We create a new one. And now we want a line graph through the scatter plot of prediction, and that is going to be our line of best fit. So we are going to choose this one, prediction wages. And our x variable is still going to be total experience, and we sort on x variables. Except, okay. As you can see, we have our line of best fit, which can be used to predict which are wages based on the total experience. Okay, now from what I can say is that you have completed our simple linear regression. Congratulations, you've just done your first simple linear regression. Maybe you've reminded yourself, it really depends. But congratulations. Next one, we're going to tackle multiple linear regression, and using the same approach is going to be fast, swift, and understandable, because that is what you do in data hacks. So make sure you subscribe and hit the bell icon. And